Welcome as we continue our Advent series, The Gatekeeper. Our reading for the second week of Advent comes from Mark's Gospel. True, this text does not directly reference the gatekeeper. Instead, it has a familiar image of one of God's messengers. Mark opened with a blend of quotes from the prophets Malachi and Isaiah, although Mark only mentions Isaiah. Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare a way for you, a voice of one who is crying out in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths. From this opening proclamation, reflect with me on the idea of the gatekeeper, the church, sending the messengers out. In all four gospel narratives, we will see that the writers express the theme of sending messengers out. In Matthew's gospel, Jesus commanded the disciples to go and baptize in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Mark's gospel states that the disciples must proclaim the gospel to every creature, driving out demons and speaking new languages. Luke's sending narrative is in the book of Acts. Jesus tells the disciples, go ye therefore to all the nations and teach to the whole world through the power of the Holy Spirit. And then in John's gospel, Jesus speaks to Peter, the first pope of the church, and he tells him to feed and tend his sheep. Certainly then, a key responsibility of the gatekeeper slash church is to send out messengers. The gatekeeper, the church, is calling her modern day disciples to go out and prepare the way for others to follow Jesus Christ during this Advent season and throughout the world, throughout the year. If you know of someone whose path is crooked or who's walking in darkness, your voice must be the one that calls them to the light. We must share profound faith and belief and knowing that if our way is crooked, we can still come back to the Lord. My friend, there is no greater gift of love we can give during this Advent season than to place a friend, a relative, or even a stranger on the path to Jesus Christ. The psalmist said, your word is a lamp unto my feet, a light for my path. We can find that in Psalm 119, 105. Friend, God's word is the lamp for our feet. God's word commands us to go into the world. The light for our path is the teaching of Jesus and the church, which helps us to expel the darkness that comes from traveling a crooked path. Oh, church, this is the air that I breathe. I breathe God's Holy Spirit calling us to prepare the way of the Lord, make straight a path to receive Jesus, the Savior of the world. Let's pray Psalm 85 together. It says, I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him. Kindness and truth shall kiss. Justice and peace will be together. Truth shall spring out of the earth and justice shall look down from heaven. Let's pray that you and I will be guided by the word of God to show someone a path to Jesus' love, a path to salvation. I look forward to seeing you next week for our third edition of The Gatekeeper. O come, Emmanuel.